All right, let's see how the GTX 1060 does in Forza Horizon 5. And the game automatically suggested the high settings. We're running the in-game benchmark. So this is the high settings preset that's recommended, but we're gonna compare it side by side with all the other settings. Let's go ahead and start out with low. You can see that while the high settings are hovering right around 60, low can jump you all the way up into the 80s, the 90s, and we'll see the final benchmark results at the end. But let's switch over to the medium comparison here. So at medium, you're definitely getting better frame rates and the game's still looking quite good. Now you could turn the textures, I think, back up to high, but I went with the preset defaults, which did lower some of the texture settings at the lower settings. Let's look at ultra. So over here at ultra, we can see that we're definitely dropping below 60 FPS, although it's still very playable. It kind of depends on exactly what sort of experience you're looking for in this game, although the high is looking really good. Now, we'll test out extreme just to get complete data results, but as you can see, that extreme seems to be more of the 30 frames per second experience. So I probably wouldn't go with that, although I know there are some people out there who are like, as long as I can get 30, lock that frame rate, and then, you know, just play with the controller, I want the max visuals possible. Well, there you go. And let's go ahead and give you the final benchmark results. We can see that the extreme settings give us an average right around 30 frames per second. Ultra is giving us around 47 on average, and high is getting us that 67 FPS. So I definitely agree with the recommendation that high is the best default. Medium drop gets us up to 75, so if you're looking for higher refresh rates. Now low gets you up to 93, but I'm not sure it's worth the trade-off. What do you guys think?